Okay, our length vector, 9 centimeters, 10 centimeters, thus has magnitude squared of 181 centimeters, approximately 13.5 centimeters, makes angle 48 degrees, measured counterclockwise from the positive x direction. And we get, we get a unit vector now by dividing the length vector by its magnitude. So, any vector we divide by its magnitude gives us a vector of magnitude 1 in the same direction. So, we divide this vector by the square root of 181 centimeters, and the centimeters divide out. We get the vector 9 over the square root of 100, square root of 181, 10 over the square root of 181. That is the unit vector. Now, that's not a real good standard form, but it doesn't really matter because we're going to go ahead and approximate it for our present purposes. So we approximate it to two significant figures, and doing the arithmetic here, 9 over the square root of 181 gives us 0.67, 10 over the square root of 181 gives us 0.74, so that we have a vector of magnitude 1, that's this vector, and you can verify that this vector has magnitude 1. Simply add the squares of these two decimal numbers, and you're going to get something very close to 1. Now, because of round off, it won't add to exactly 1, but it will add to within plus or minus about 0.01 of 1, meaning that its magnitude is going to be within round off error equal to 1. Okay, and it's going to also make angle 48 degrees, because as we've seen, when you multiply or divide a vector by a positive number, you don't change its direction. Okay, the slope is still the same. The rise over the run, the y over the x, would be the same for this vector as it is for this vector. Okay. Now, we multiply this unit vector by 12 newtons. Okay? So if we multiply the unit vector by 12 newtons, what do we get? We get 12 newtons times the vector, 0.67, 0.74. And that gives us approximately 8 newtons, and as the x component, and the y component, 8.9 newtons. So the unit vector here multiplied by 12 newtons gives us this vector here. Now, 12 newtons is a force. So when we multiply this unitless vector, because let's note again that the centimeters divided out, this vector has no units. But when we multiply it by some number in newtons, we do get a vector whose components are in newtons and whose magnitude will be in newtons. What's the magnitude of this vector? Well, we're multiplying 12 newtons by a vector of magnitude 1. The vector that we get is going to have magnitude of 12 newtons times 1, or just 12 newtons. So this is a vector of magnitude 12 newtons, and its angle is still approximately 48 degrees. It's the same as the angle of the original length vector. So now we have a force vector in the direction of the length vector with the force that we choose, with the force that we want it to have. Now you might ask, what good is this? Well, here we have, can you see this? Yeah, that ought to be pretty good. We have a rubber band stretched between this point and this point. And this rubber band is 13.5 centimeters long. You can take my word for that, but it's not really true. But let's pretend it is actually 13.5 centimeters long. It's actually closer to 10 centimeters. It also makes an angle of 48 degrees with the positive x direction. Here's a positive x direction. There's a 48 degree angle. And that angle's probably pretty close to 48 degrees. Now, if by hanging dominoes from this rubber band, we were able to determine that at that length, 13.5 centimeters, it exerts a tension force of 12 newtons. That is, there's a force down at this end that's pulling in this direction on this paper clip. Okay, the rubber band is pulling in this direction on the paper clip here, and it's exerting a force of 12 newtons. Okay, now it's not really 13.5 centimeters long. The force is more like a couple of newtons, but let's just say if we had a thicker rubber band and stretched it out properly, we could easily get a 12 newton force along the length of the rubber band. Now, the vector, the length vector for that rubber band would be 9 centimeters, 10 centimeters, if it was actually 13.5 centimeters long at angle 48 degrees. It would be very close to this vector. Then, the unit vector in the same direction would still be this, and when we multiply that unit vector by 12 newtons, we get the components of the force. So the force exerted by this rubber band is equivalent to a force of 8 newtons in the x direction and 8.9 newtons in the y direction. If we were to exert forces of 8 newtons this way and 8.9 newtons this way, it would have exactly the same effect as this one single force at 48 degrees. Okay, so that's what that's good for, and that's going to lead us to a lot of interesting analysis. Now let me just remind you of where we would get that 12 newtons. Remember when you did the graph of the force tension in the rubber band versus length, suspending various numbers of dominoes, and of course your force was in domino weights and your length was in centimeters or some measurement from a reduced ruler, centimeters T, centimeters D, whatever. But same thing, and we could easily convert the information you got to force in newtons versus length in centimeters. Now, for a certain rubber band, the curve might look like this, and at 13.5 centimeters, we get a force of 12 newtons. So for that rubber band at 13.5 centimeter length at 48 degrees, right here is our force vector. And where does the 9 centimeter, 10 centimeter come in here? Well, our measurements, 9 centimeters this way, 10 centimeters this way, gives us 13.5 centimeter length and the 48 degree angle.